It shows the growth of our township from 1968 to today. As you can see, we have significant more population, more roads, more pretty much everything. The office where the police department is housed was added on in 1975. At that time, there were 3 part-time police officers and 1 admin person. Today, we have 10 officers and support personnel that work out of there, and the admin offices have grown to 4 people. Back in, the administration building used to be in with the police department and the public works, and in 2001, the township renovated the social quarters of the firehouse, and the admin administrative offices were moved over there where we are today. The current salt shed was constructed in 1994, actually by our road crew. It's 800 square feet and holds 150 tons of salt. In an average 3-inch storm, we use 100 to 120 tons of salt. So as you can imagine, this can become problematic and has been problematic when we have a very large storm, as we did in 2015, when we had 36 inches and 24 hours, or if we have severe back-to-back storms, we can and we have run out of salt. This is a list of some, not all, of the equipment and vehicles that we have. As you can see, I'm sure many of you have been over there, a lot of it's housed outside. So some of the concerns that the commissioners looked at as they were developing this project, which has gone over 4 years, were limited security on the outside of the building, no break room or training room for police or public works. Currently, the police officers work 12-hour shifts, and they take their breaks at their desk. The road crew have a picnic table behind one of the trucks where they take their breaks. The salt shed is in extremely poor condition and not adequate to meet the needs of the 36 miles of roads we have. As you saw on the previous slide, our old road mileage was down around 22 miles, so that's grown significantly. There's a lot of exterior problems. The commissioners did have an inspector come in and do both buildings. The bones of the building were actually pretty good, but of course, it needs a lot of work, roof, windows, doors. It's not capable of becoming ADA accessible, which it's grandfathered because it was built so long ago. That's one of the reasons that the commissioners renovated the social quarters of the fire department and moved the meeting room over there so that it was handicapped accessible. That was a big thing in their considerations. So in 2001, as I previously mentioned, the fire company social hall was renovated and the administration department and public meeting rooms were moved over there. The way some of this came about, in 2014, there was a building on Willow and Diamond Street, the Matlock Building. It went up for sale. It had 4 bays, a fenced-in lot area, and a significant amount of office space. So the township looked into possibly purchasing that building for both police and public works. They went through probably a year of negotiations, investigations. Ultimately, it was purchased by somebody else. So after that, in 2014 and 2015, they tried to figure out how to meet the needs of all departments, fire, admin, police, public works. As you can imagine, this was a huge undertaking, and a lot of ideas were thrown back and forth. They looked at the township for land to possibly build one big complex. They really didn't find anything suitable. They looked for other buildings similar to the Matlock Building. Again, there's really nothing suitable out there. So then, during talks, they decided to pinpoint focus on the public works department. And one of the reasons is it was very important that all the departments be able to keep operating to protect the safety of our residents while whatever was being constructed is being constructed. So the thought process was build a new public works building, move public works into it, and then renovate the current building either for police or one of the other departments. And this was let all of the departments continue to operate. In October of 2014, the commissioners asked the engineers to put together a study, because one of the questions that came up, as it did Monday night, was, well, can we rehab our current building and have it meet the current and future needs of our community. So LTL did a study. I apologize, this doesn't show very well, but the light dashed lines show the right-of-way, the setbacks for the township, and the dark line is the right-of-way from Route 100. So as you can see, our current salt shed is actually in the right-of-way, which is a no-no. But because of the odd shape of the lot and the required setbacks, there really is not enough area to add on to this current building and meet the needs of all the departments. So conceptual study was, one of the concepts that was brought up was putting the public works building on the same lot, which is almost six acres, it's 5.84 acres. And one of the parameters that the commissioners told them was that they don't want any improvements to impact the current recreational facility. And this explains a little bit about what they found. Given the need for more storage and the odd shape of the property, they recommend that we build a new building. And then once Public Works was relocated, then the existing building could possibly be renovated for police. And then these were just conceptual diagrams showing that, yes, it is possible to fit the police departments into the current building. Again, strictly a concept, not a plan. And then also a conceptual garage layout showing possible size. At that time, 100 by 140 was being contemplated. As you can see in later drawings, as the design went through, we actually downgraded that to 80 by 150, which is 12,000 square feet instead of 14,000. So the next steps, in January 2016, the commissioners formed the building committee to get prices and design for the new public works building. At that time, Douglas Township was also building, they were farther along in the process of designing their building, and they were estimating about the $800,000 for a similar size building. In March 21st of 2016, the township held a conditional use hearing because municipal use was allowed on the property with conditional use. And the thought at that time was this was a good time to notify the neighbors of what was going on. So 74 properties that were within 500 feet got registered letters, and two came to the meeting. The conditional use was granted. And then in 16 and 17, the design of the building continued in conjunction with the township's code department. So this was a really, really long process. We wanted to make sure whatever was designed met all the applicable codes. We did run into a couple road bumps. I did not know it was going to be a sprinkler system, so that was a bit of a surprise. But so we wanted to make sure the design could be built to code. And then in May 24th, 2017, the project went out to bid to give us hard numbers. And in September 14th of 17, the bids were received, which, as you're all aware. So the proposed building will be 12,000 square feet with seven bays. Our current building has three bays. It will include 1,760 feet of office space, which will include offices, lockers, ADA accessible bathrooms, and a break room that will have holding pots for when the township road crew has to work for 6 hours straight because of a snowstorm, give them some place to rest. They're also proposing an emergency generator, and this will allow that building to be used also as an emergency management center. Back in 2010, we had that bad storm and electric was out for over a week. Residents would be able to come to the building and use showers or get rest or whatever they would need. And this is a conceptual layout with the current dimensions, just showing that all the equipment can be stored inside, along with workstations, wash bays, and maintenance bays. Another consideration that came up during the design of the building was one of the commissioners suggested, why don't we add solar to it? So we did some investigative and we found out from PICO that we could credit all of our electric use on facilities within a 2 mile radius through net metering. This savings is approximately $22,000 and would pay for the solar itself plus approximately 14% of other costs through the savings of electric, and this would grow over time as electric costs go up, which I'm sure they will. Another consideration is the proposed salt shed. It's proposed to be 2,000 square feet and could hold 1,000 tons of salt. One of the considerations is, one of the reasons we made it so big is so that we could stockpile salt. There's many times when we can get salt at a severely reduced price and make sure we have enough of it for when the emergencies come along, if we had the ability to stockpile it. Also, it would provide greater safety for our residents in that we would never have to worry about running out of salt. Some of the handouts included the bids that came in for Public Works, and we also have these posted online, and a breakdown of the cost. As Elwood mentioned, funding for to finance the cost of the project has already been budgeted and will not require an increase. This shows you the cost of the Public Works building came to $1,264,82, and then of course you get the site work, the salt shed, the solar, the generator, and you come up with the total. Just as a comparison, as I explained before, Douglas Montgomery is, they're actually in, under construction for their Public Works building.